tell you something very secret. We don't need to get married.
I would say exactly the same thing.
At the end of the day, I'm Italian.
He's the neediest boyfriend that there is in the world. So now let me show you what I've done. This is where I'm gonna spend my next hour. Now I'm gonna sound like so silly in this video. Hello my favorite people and welcome to a new video. Normally I would start a video by saying good morning, but this is like one of very, very few rare instances where I actually start a new video in the evening. Quite an evening, in fact. It is 7:57 p.m. You might recognize that I'm wearing the same top as at the very end of the last video. That's because I literally just finished the last video half an hour ago. So I was not gonna start a new vlog, but I was thinking, today I was gonna take a day off. It didn't work out. It doesn't look like it's gonna work out anytime soon, this whole day off situation. But I did have a little pedicure. Since I came back from Marbella, which is basically 24 hours, I just decided to give myself as much pampering, health, good food, good supplements, good hydration, good everything, like just like a little bit of love and care, etc. And you know what the difference is? The difference when you're like trying to take supplements or give yourself care to fix something, the difference between that mentality and mentality of saying, hey, my body's brought me to so many different places, it's been working so well, it's so great to me, I need to give it some love. And that's me right now. I'm so grateful for my body, for the health, for its energy. It's bringing me from place to place. It's helping me do what I want to do. And I'm so grateful to it that I've decided to give it literally like 3 days of pampering. So first of all, we're gonna remove this little bit of makeup that I have on. I don't know if you can see. I recently in Paris also went to New Age Paris to do a little microneedling treatment and a hydrofacial. I desperately needed it. My skin was like screaming for it. And it's giving me a nice glow, but I wanna do such a post-treatment care that the results are even better. So I'm gonna show you, actually, no gatekeeping here. You guys know your girl. So I'm just gonna show you what I'm gonna do as a little extra care. Let's go remove the makeup.
Not really gonna film thoroughly the makeup removal process. I think you all know how that's done, but I'm just going to use this Tata Harper oil to remove it. And also I'm gonna try and tie back the hair in a low bun or a low ponytail. I'll explain later why.
I put a cotton pajama on, not because I wanna sleep. You're gonna find out in a second why. It's like basically linen cotton PJs from White Company. I'll link it below if I can find it. But I also have cotton socks here. I need them, and I removed all of my jewelry. Oh my God, I have 10 lines from jewelry already. I'll show you what I'm gonna do now. Here we go. My pillow looks like that because I've done this also last night and I didn't change my bedding just yet because it was fresh after I came back from my trip. So I got my infrared sauna here on top of the bed. I set it up for 7. Last night, I think I did 8, I believe. I don't know, but it was like really intense. I remember I was sweating. So I'm gonna wait for it to heat up. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna apply some moisturizing ointment on my feet and put on cotton socks. You don't need to do that. It's actually great to sweat out as much as you can. So I don't apply anything on my body, but on my feet I will, just because I think like it's great to keep them moisturized, so it's like different kind of effect. And then we're gonna get in. That's the plan. Time to get in.
Let's do 20 minutes.
Okay guys, so here is where we're at. I'm obviously, when I stop vlogging, gonna put my arms inside as well, but I wanted to tell you a little bit. I don't know if you can take me seriously while I look like this. Hopefully yes. However, I'm gonna tell you what's up. So I put the infrared blanket on the bed. This is not sponsored. I bought everything that you can see in this video with my own money. I have 2 different LED masks. Actually, I have 3. This one is just easier when traveling because it lays flat, but I think the other one that I have is a little bit better. However, with the other one, I like have to have my full face closed. I can't talk much. It's not very easy, like if I'm gonna film and stuff. So infrared, it's like basically very hot inside, like sauna in my body, but you adjust to the temperature you need. You put on a cotton pajama or like a hoodie or whatever you want on, and then you get in. The point is that it's supposed to, like, it heals your body. So, like, if you have any sprained muscles, joints, it promotes recovery, it detoxes your body, you sweat in it, so obviously it detoxes. And it's, like, I don't know how many times I'll put on screen, better for detoxing than actual sauna. I also prepare for myself. Here's, like, some water with electrolytes, collagen, and vitamins that I mix up myself, basically. I also have some lip balm that I'm gonna apply right away. And then on my lap is my computer, which I'm gonna play something really iconic. Like, on this occasion, it's gonna be The Hills. I don't know if you guys watch The Hills, if you know The Hills, but it's iconic. So that's that. I set up my LED mask for 20 minutes, but I'm gonna do 1 hour in the infrared blanket. So I'm gonna do 3 times 20 minutes, which is a lot, but it's great after microneedling treatment. These blankets are great, like I said, for recovery, but also for detoxing. And I have a lot of friends that are not in my age bracket. I have, like, friends that are, obviously I have friends in their 20s, in their 30s, in their 40s, but also in their 50s and even in their 60s, okay? I personally have certain body issues already at my age, and body doesn't really get better, unfortunately, as we use it throughout the age. But, like, yesterday when I came back from my trip, because I was, like, lagging these luggages around, something was hurting me on my left shoulder. And I do have issues with my left shoulder. I mentioned it a few times. But, guys, it, like, literally already today feels better. So I'm going to put my whole body in so that it can work on my left shoulder, because it really, really heals body and it helps with that. And if you don't, like, trust a little silly girl online, ask around. This is where I'm going to spend my next hour, while hydrating as well. That's very important. Good morning, guys. We're back at the usual place. As you guys can see, I have still not filled in this shoe gap over here. I know it's surprising, but don't worry. I've done, like, as you guys know, significant amount of shopping in Paris. I still have some boxes to open in the corridor. I still have stuff here, look, that needs to go in my wardrobe. And I'm actually coming to you with some really incredible items that I'm gonna show you. Well, first of all, as you can probably see, I just dyed my hair because after the infrared sauna, I wanted to do, like, a proper hair mask and everything. So it's, like, back in a bun. And I'm wearing this top that you have seen now hundreds of times because I just love it so much. It's the top that I got from Lily Silk. It's, like, sort of a sweetheart cut, beautiful navy top, and I'm wearing it with my 10 motif Van Cleef necklace with agate. This is, I think, my favorite one that I have. I just love the blue. I would like to show you a few items that I got for spring summer from Lily Silk. Lily Silk is an incredible brand that does, actually, I just realized the pants from Lily Silk as well, but I'm embarrassed to show them to you because you guys know that I wear these pants almost on a daily basis, and they're like the cashmere Lily Silk pants. And anyway, I have, like, quite a few pieces from Lily Silk that I wear on repeat, starting with the tops, with the cashmere knits. I think their cashmere is just incredible, as well as their silk items. The first item that I got is not going to be a surprise to you because you know how much I've worn this one. So I basically decided to get the very same top in just a different color. Over here we have this kind of, like, taupey color. It's a mulberry silk knitted stretchable. It's, like, so comfortable but so elegant also. I love the sweetheart neck, and I love that it's just, like, easy to style with everything and anything, and you, like, pack it in your suitcase. Like, this is how small you can pack it in your suitcase. And it's perfect also when you travel with hand luggage and things like that. I personally love Lily Silk tops because I just think they're so versatile. On that note, I decided to get another one. But before we go into that, I just wanted to give you a little surprise. As always, you will get a special discount if you use my special code that I asked Lily Silk to give for my audience. So if you use TK20, you will get 20% off. But if you spend over, I believe, £480, and you use TK25, you will get 25% off. Quarter off is pretty good deal. Happy shopping. I will link each item below in the description box so you guys can find everything that you like. The second item that I got, yet another top, and I really, really love this type of top. I think it looks kind of preppy and cute. I'll come close so you can see the material. It's silk knitted stretchable material, and it's, like, knitted in a way that it's, like, I'll take it off the hanger so you guys can see it, so that it's really breathable, comfortable. I love the white color, the kind of navy and white, so
cute. It's that type of like really luxurious, beautiful top that you can style with white trousers or with the denim or denim shorts. One thing that can just check so many different boxes. I also like the button-up V-neck collar, and I just like the simple design that really will take you a long way. I don't know what you guys think, and I love the detailing. I did not stop myself there when it comes to tops, because yes, I like this kind of like knitted version of tops, but I had to get something that is also silk, because especially in the summer, I love silk pieces, okay? I think I've spoken about this before. I think this olive green, now I'm gonna sound like so silly in this video, just telling you that I think everything suits me well. But I do think that olive green suits me well. And I realized that when Filippo pointed it out, actually, so it doesn't seem like I look at myself and I'm like, ooh, I look so good in this. No, Filippo pointed out that this color, maybe because my skin tone is a little bit like olive undertone, I don't know, but I really, really love this kind of shirt. So this is a silk double joe, super, super friendly to your skin, breathable, comfortable, lovely. Obviously, this looks very smart and you can wear it for whatever occasion you want to wear it, but I love to wear this unbuttoned over a bikini. Now imagine this shirt over my Gucci bikini, you know, the like classic one I got last summer, just this unbuttoned, open, beachside. That's the kind of stuff that I really, really love. Silk tops for me are everything. And on that note, I think I got another two silk tops. Now, this style I loved so much and I couldn't decide which color I wanted it in. So I got both colors, because you know what you need to do when you can't decide which color of a top or an item or shoes or whatever to get. You get them both. What I really love about this top is the cowl neck detailing, sort of like it's boat neck. I think both colors extremely beautiful. Look. Which one would you get, navy or gray? Navy is like one of those colors I love. I think like especially love it ever since I got my Birkin cargo, because I love to style that bag even more. Even with this necklace, this would be so beautiful. It's such an easy top to style. It's like also I think a little bit sexy because of the boat neck. I think also what's really great about this top is that it's perfect for both vacation or for work, because as much as it's like very beautiful and attractive, it's also like not in any way like too revealing or anything like that. So it just ticks all the boxes and I really personally love it. Also like under a jacket, under a blazer, or not, styled with a skirt, styled with trousers, whatever, literally whatever you want. One thing that I've been looking for high and low, and you guys know this because I've mentioned it several times on the channel, is a pair of white trousers. Now I'm gonna show you a pair of white trousers that I got from Lily Silk. What I love about this is like I've tried a ton of white trousers, but these are like 40 millimeter thick silk, and that silk is like wrinkle free. It's perfect to travel, you know, like you don't want obviously creased trousers by the end of the day, so these are great for that. It just like feels really light, breathable, like beautiful. I feel like it's such a classic staple. It's a must have if you ask me, a pair of white trousers. And honestly, I have like a few, but nothing like this light and beautiful for the summer. I'll bring it closer so you guys can see it. I also like the side slit pockets, you know, easy and practical. And I could even style it with this top that I'm wearing right now. Okay, over here we have a Charmeuse silk dress with this detailing on the side. It's kind of like a ring, like a ruched ring, golden with a bit of a detailing. I don't know if you can see. And I love this chocolate brown color. Like, I'm not gonna say I also think this colors so well, because that's too much. This is Charmeuse silk, like I said, designed to like basically provide a perfect fit, because it's a midi dress. It's gorgeous. It's simple in front and back, carefully tailored. I don't know if you can see with all this stitching. Love it. It's such a elegant piece, but also can be styled different ways with high heels or with flats or even with sneakers. So you can wear it for pretty much any occasion. Now, I think you guys know that I love pieces like this. This is 100% silk fabric. It is a sort of midi slash maxi skirt, a little bit of a like an A-line. It's called like an umbrella skirt, and it has, again, pockets, which is what I love. I would love to wear this with like a very fitted top and Oran sandals for the summer. I actually have like several white, off-white, champagne color, golden, gray skirts like this for the season, and I just love them. I love the fit. They're always very comfortable and really, really flattering to the figure. Another one that I absolutely love is this silk knitted dress. Beautiful neck, first of all. Look at the color. Gorgeous. Similar to the other top that I got from this style. I love the kind of like ribbed
skirt, and I love that it's like this kind of silhouette that is very, very trendy, but also elegant and timeless, I would say. Very like light, but beautifully knitted. It's basically worn off shoulder, as you guys will see. And I think that my whole wardrobe is perfect, like to go with this dress. Like all of the sandals I have, all of the bags I have are just made to go with this. And obviously this, you don't have to worry about any kind of creases or anything like that. There's a bag next to me, this one, and I just grabbed it. And I feel like even these two could go so well together. You know what I mean? This is like one of those pieces that whatever you grab will go with it because it's like a perfect neutral. I know you might be thinking that is it, but that is not it. I got one more piece. Here we got a one shoulder, beautiful silk top. This is like pearl-like glossy charmeuse silk. I don't know if you can see, with beautiful detailing and even this like tassel. I think this is so beautiful and quite like sexy, but again, nothing is revealing. You'll have to wait to see this piece, what it looks like on, because like this, I can't give it like right justice because I think it's such a beautiful, beautiful, beautiful item. I'm actually packing to go to Saint-Tropez very soon. And I believe I'm gonna pack some of these pieces, like specifically tops and also dresses. Like this could be really nice. I'm just looking at what I have and my silk off the shoulder tops, because it's just like a piece you put on with like a pair of like maybe like Chanel jeans or like the Loewe pants or something like that, you know, to make it like create a contrast. So that could be really cute. I actually have to tidy this wardrobe today. There's a lot of new stuff coming in. And then I need to organize it because I know that I'm gonna have like such a season of packing, packing, packing back to back, like holidays and all the like incredible things that I wanna be ready for. So don't forget to check the description box, and don't forget that you have TK20 for 20% off. Or if you buy a few pieces and you spend more than £480, then you can use TK25 for 25% off, which I think is amazing. So right now, I have like my team at home. We're gonna do some work. I'm gonna bring you probably for some of those things out. I'm trying to eat like very healthy, like I told you. I'm trying to give myself care and detox and all of that. I'm gonna do a bit of like a hair care as well, which I might show you as well in this video, so that it's a bit of like a giving love to self. I think this dress is one of my favorites, and I also love kind of how it moves. You guys know I love that. I'm very much into that. Styled it with the run sandals and like kind of keeping in neutral tones, but then obviously this pochette is invert fits, so it brings a little bit of a sagey tones from the dress as well. I just love that it's coming to the season of my pochette, because I know I'll wear it all summer long. This bag, you kind of throw in your bag and it goes with every outfit. I don't understand how, because I remember when I got it, I really wanted a pochette and I got this color, but I was thinking, do we think that I'm gonna wear this color, like light green? Honestly, it's unbelievable. I love it so much. I couldn't not style this very same dress also with a pair of heels. These are like kind of olive grainy shoes from Armarium, super comfortable. The heel's not too high, like a glove with a heel basically for your feet. And I don't know if I've ever shown you my new Margot. It's one size bigger than a 10. I love it. I've already worn it a few times, and I think it's just such a gorgeous everyday bag, because also like if I need my earphones and things like that, this fits. So yeah, very easy, a little bit more elegant look, but also work appropriate. Okay guys, this is like a more elegant version of how I would style this chocolate brown dress. I decided to add some burgundy accents, and I just realized as well, this is the new Chanel wallet on a chain. What I really love about this bag is initially I bought it to be a beauty case, but obviously it can be worn as a bag as well. It's quite cute. So this is my more like dressy version of styling this dress. However, you can also go a little bit more casual if you want. Okay, this is like my version of more casual. You can style it like this, and I love this. I'm wearing the Ro blazer, the Ro half moon bag. Written a blog post about this bag. I love it so much. I worn it a lot. I'm so happy. I packed it actually when I was going to Venice, and then I took it out of the suitcase last minute, so it got saved. I'm wearing my Lizard Oran kind of purpley burgundy-ish sandals. But yeah, this is like a more casual version, also like without a blazer or with, however you like. But I think this dress is super versatile. I think I changed my mind. This is my favorite look. I'm loving the white trousers, the sandals, styling with my Constance in indigo. also like gold matches the gold at the bottom, and we have like this beautiful detailing of the blue. It's kind of like a royal colors. I don't know, is there such a thing? But for me, this look is really great. I love it, and I love the white trousers. They're perfect length for me. I love it. Also, I need to wear this bag a little bit more. I feel like I'm not giving her enough airtime. Okay, we have the same trousers in a different version, this time styled with the Chanel flats with my Hermes Kelly. I belted them in as well. I think this makes them look a little bit more casual, but obviously you don't have to do that. I just wanted to connect the black toe cap and the belt. Also another bag that I feel like I need to wear more. I probably will now that it's warmer weather, and I'm starting to think that I love the silver top even more than navy. What do you guys think? The skirt, I think, is so elegant. It's so beautiful. It would go really well with the heels, but I also decided to wear it as like an elegant flat version, because like not every, for example, if you want to wear it on your holidays, not every city is heel friendly. So styled it like kind of to complement the silvery gray of the top with the gray orange, and I even brought a little blue boom mini Kelly to bring out the kind of cooler tones. Okay, I read the comments. I know many of you prefer more elegant vibes, so here's the more elegant version of kind of like styling this dress with the top that I first shown you, as well as a little bit of a kitten heel. Now obviously you can go also all the way high heel, but honestly nowadays, unless I'm going to like an evening event, I rarely ever wear high heels. I know it's a little bit strange, but it's a fact, as well as my Elan Kelly. I love it. I personally prefer it more with the flat shoes, but I just wanted to show you that obviously it can be worn so many different ways. When I wear it like this, I feel a little bit like my mom, because this is exactly what my mom would wear, which is amazing, because it means that this skirt is appropriate for literally any age and every age, and that's one thing that I think is so beautiful. Guys, I'm obsessed. This top is the same color as my favorite trousers from the row, and I think that is match made in heaven. I decided to style it with the blue jean Constance. I haven't really worn this bag yet, and I think this would be a perfect color combo. I should have maybe gotten the same color orange. I haven't, but I also don't like too matchy-matchy, so I styled it with the white Chypre sandals, and I love it. I love that this is so versatile. Obviously it would go so well also with a pair of jeans, which we can also try right now. Guys, these are the new jeans that I just got in the last video, so I thought like, why not style them until I can get my hands on the Totem ones I lost. Loving this, like lots of neutral colors, kind of cool ballerina style, bare ankles, I love that look. Okay guys, this top is just, I love it. I really, really, really love it. It's such a versatile piece. Look at the color, beautiful. Goes really well with my cargo, like I said, with the jeans, with a pair of loafers, and this is a great like everyday look. Obviously you can tuck also the top inside of the denim with a bit of a belt. I feel like I need maybe a navy belt. Do I have a navy belt? Maybe I have a navy belt. This could be a really cute look. Maybe in London, like not so hot, not so cold days, you know what I mean. Another way of styling this top would be with white trousers or jeans, keeping it like white and navy, like very kind of nautical vibes. I love it. But it's just like a very simple, very easy look. And I think it looks somehow, like, I don't know if it's the colors, if it's the materials, the way it flows, looks very luxurious. What do you think with this bag? My Constance alligator mat. What are the thoughts? Such a beautiful, airy, light piece. I'm loving these aquamarine vibes, like a sage green, a little bit of touch of blue, light green, a bit of white. You know, it's just like all the kind of sea colors in a way. Not all, but you know what I mean. I love the combo as well. I think also these colors go really well with like very popular butter yellow or even navy. It's like very chic look, basically. That's it, bottom line is that. Here we go, let me know what you guys think. And a little bit more elegant but shorts version, kind of like a holiday evening look. We got these Neos heels, Pochette Invert fits. These are Hermes shorts I got last summer, and the silk top. And I feel like this is like perfect for an evening. I really like it. The heels are very, very, very comfortable, because I've had these heels since 2020, actually. I really like them. I don't know if they're still available online. If I can find them, I will link them below. I got the same like Jill Sander version of them. I got the row version kind of them. And honestly, none of them made it as much as these. So I really love them. Let me know which outfit you guys like the most. Good morning, everybody. It's a new day. And I wasn't actually gonna vlog right now. I just did a tiny little bit of makeup. I wasn't gonna vlog, basically. I applied a ton of serum into my roots because I'm gonna wash my hair right after some morning calls. So I'm gonna sneak it back for the morning calls. My phone's ringing. Who could it be? Filippo, I bet I knew it. Yes, my love?
Always very important calls from Filippo, and you know what? It's always changing plans, basically, last minute. We were supposed to spend a weekend in Saint-Tropez. He's like, maybe not, I don't know. Anyway, I'm not even gonna discuss that with you. I'm trying to figure out how this hair can look at least okay for this portion of the video. Just ignore it, okay? I wanted to show you something that I received from Gucci, and it's already unboxed, so at least I'll spare you the unboxing part. It's basically here. This is the part of Gucci summer kit. We have a hat with this colorful Gucci kind of like logo, I guess, writing. Then this little raffia marmont bag. There's a pareo in the matching colors. The burgundy sunglasses. I actually really like these sunglasses. I wore them during the cruise shows, you guys remember. They are quite cute. I really like how they suit me. I'll show you in a second. And then this tote over here that is in like a blue on blue monogram, and inside a recognizable Gucci stripe. And there's a little like a pochette pouch kind of vibe inside where you can put your, like on the beach, you can put your phone or sunglasses or whatever you want. Let me show you the sunnies. You've seen them before, so that's what I wore at the cruise show. They're quite cute, actually, the sunglasses. I already have a burgundy pair of sunglasses, also from Gucci, from the previous collection, but I also really like these. I think they're very, very, very nice. I was just worried I'm not gonna fit the hat because I have a very big head, but actually it fits. I'm not sure if I would wear this, to be very honest with you guys, but one thing that I'm sure is that this is really good to protect me from the sun, especially because you guys know I like to protect my face skin from the UV rays, so that's important. One funny thing about this tote bag is when I saw it, it really, really brought back so many memories. And that's because when I just graduated, I think, there was this similar version of that bag and it was in beige color. And I really wanted that bag for like kind of day to day, like it would fit books, agenda, my iPad. At the time I was going nowhere without my iPad because I was reading all my books on the iPad. I was writing my blog posts and I was checking Blog Loving. That used to be a platform at the beginning of blogging days for like getting updated on everything blog related. I was taking every day to work 1 hour bus ride, so I really need like a big bag that will fit everything. I saw this girl, she came into the pharmacy carrying this Gucci bag, and I was like, oh, I loved it so much. I really wanted it, and then eventually I finally got it. I was so happy about it, and it also had a little pouch inside, just like this one, and it was just like a beige, classic, very similar to this though, but it was a little bit sturdier, like different kind of vibes. It kind of marked the beginning days of my blogging in a way, so I thought I'd share that story. And then also something really cute that I received, already unboxed it on my TikTok, so maybe you've already seen it, I'm not sure. I'm really loving these pocket blushes. It's so pigmented, you guys. This one is quite nice already. What I like is that you can just blend it in with your fingers, you know what I mean? Sleepy Girl, yeah, I really like the Sleepy Girl. I like Freckle as well, and Piggy. Piggy is more like this kind of romantic pink. How cute, and so easy to blend, and so pigmented. That's why I guess it's called the pocket blush. I really love what Rhode's been doing. I love the products, the packaging, it's so cute, the marketing. I just love when it's like kind of a female-led business that has such great ideas. I'm really impressed. I also got some new peptide lip treatments. They're not as bright as they look in the tube, and I like that. Let me try and apply this kind of nudie one, which is in shade Salty Tan. I've overlined my lips quite a bit today, as you can see on top of the cupid bow. Really sweet. I love this. I have some exciting news. My beauty table will be arriving. Actually, it's ready. It just needs to arrive. But since we're going to be in Saint-Tropez, I think we're going to go to Saint-Tropez first, and then we're going to ask them to deliver it next, because we want to be at home when the table arrives, because I'm not sure yet where I'm going to put it. Also, today I realized how much my baby hair has grown. I have a full set of new short hair, like all over. I have so much new hair, you guys. This is not fringe, because I know my fringe is like till here now. So I have so much new hair, it's crazy. And it's all because I've been trying and testing something. It's not like sponsored anything or nothing like that. It's not like, you know, an influencer says, I've been trying and testing something, and I'll let you know as soon as I can. I really didn't want to talk about it until I was sure, and now I'm like, I was shocked. I'll give you all the updates as soon as I can. But now, first things first, I have a call at 11 and it's 10:51, so perfect time.
Back with much better hair, I would say, at least, if you ask me.
Me too.
You too?
But
you too?
Baby, we went to the hairdresser together.
Baby, I was gonna announce you as a secret guest.
Okay, let's do it again.
Let's do it again. Yeah. Let's pretend this didn't happen. Guys, you will not believe who I'm finally in the car with, but I'm so happy that my best friend, partner, a husband, a fiancé.
I can't be fiancé and husband.
It's just tricky because I'm already telling everywhere and you're telling everybody I'm your wife and I'm telling everybody you have.
Yeah, that's why I think we don't need to get married. Baby, I'm serious.
To be honest, baby, nothing would change.
Right?
But you know, at the end of like some kind of core, we are a little bit traditional like that.
I cannot wait to call you my husband. Also for us, I think I can talk for both of us.
Yeah.
The wedding is more a celebration of love shared with our friends.
Yeah. It's so funny, we never discussed that, what wedding is for us, and I would say exactly the same thing.
No, but it has a no value in between you and me.
Celebrating the fact that we're becoming one bigger family.
For me, the moment I proposed you, mm-hmm. it was the moment I felt like now we are a family. We're not anymore a man and a woman that really love each other. After the engagement, then you're a family. Wedding is for the others.
I think like maybe the church ceremony is quite important.
It is if you are, you know, very religious, because you promising in front of your God.
Like religious wedding, exactly. Whatever religion you are exactly. from, you know? Well, what do you think, guys, where are we going tonight? You have a few seconds to guess. Maybe we're so predictable. I think like people in Milan can bet on which restaurant we go which night.
Yeah.
It's a safe bet. Oh baby, look at that lady that's getting on a motorbike. She's got a beautiful caddy. So we're going for a pizza margherita or due. I actually am really craving pizza, but at the same time I'm just really excited to sit with Filippo. So Filippo came home last night quite late, and I can tell you something, I was so happy when I heard his voice. I felt like a puppy. When?
Because you know, I was telling today a friend of mine, it's been a long time. We've been apart for 2 weeks.
No, baby. No. Since Monday. That just seems like it was that long. I agree. Also,
Monday?
For me. Baby, Monday?
You went
we
to
were
Paris.
Both?
Yeah. And me?
He came to Paris with me, but then he went to Milan.
From Saint-Tropez?
Yeah, from Monaco.
1 week. Wow. I want to say something quite funny. And I was in London and I went to for business, and I went to Wimbledon for business, and I was watching a game in the central court. I was watching Novak. Mm-hmm. I was just it was luck. I was there yesterday and Novak was playing. In front of me there was a girl and a couple, I think, I don't know. And at some point I'm supporting Novak, obviously, because he's my hero. He scored the point and I was like, I stand up and I said, "Idemo!" And then the girl in front of me, she had a ventaglio. How do you call it?
Lepesa.
She was with a Lepesa, with a Serbian flag.
Yeah?
Yeah. And cool. She turned around and she said, "Excuse me, did you say Idemo?" I said, "Yes." And she said, "Are you Tamara's husband?" I said, "I am." I said, "Oh my God, guys, I love you so much. Can I take a picture?" I said, "Of course." But you know, when those things happen, whenever I go, that there is a Serbian, it could be a Serbian soccer player, a Serbian tennis player, there is always a lot of Serbians, because you guys support your athletes so much. And it's always like, there is always so many, maybe, people that loves you.
Love that story.
I love it too. I love it too. I never bothered by, this. Never, ever, ever. I actually enjoy it very much. If you see me, come say hi.
Filippo finds it like such a pleasure to meet you guys.
When they show any kind of appreciation towards you, it makes me feel so proud.
I love it.
Anyway, go. What was your question?
If you could eat one meal for the rest of your life, which meal would it be?
This question, baby, is impossible. I'm sorry.
One meal would be pizza.
It's impossible,
night.
It depends. You say pizza, right? But then if I tell you gnocchi pomodoro. Maybe if I tell you melanzane alla parmigiana.
No, gnocchi pomodoro.
Yeah, so it's not pizza anymore.
No, I think it's still pizza, to be honest.
Look, if you ask my mom, she will tell you gnocchi. 100%.
Yeah?
Yeah, baby, I was obsessed with gnocchi, also because my mother used to do it handmade, you know? Yeah, I don't know, very difficult. But yeah, it's in between pasta and pizza. At the end of the day, I'm Italian. But I love sushi, I love fish.
Yeah?
If you go to Ibiza, you know, we did a takeover with Off-White. So we have an event there, it was amazing. But if you go to Ibiza, guys, go to Yondal, because the food is another level. Because, I'll tell you something, very secret. The chef of Yondal has some, you know, amazing connection with the fishermen in the port of Ibiza.
That's funny.
And that's how it works, you know? And you always get the best of the best.
So baby, something strange is happening to me. I'm so sleepy, I cannot stop yawning.
Baby, me too.
Another exciting thing, you guys, that I'd like to share with you is that today is the first time ever that I decided to bring out this bag. And I'm very, very, very excited about it because I think it's so precious. So I really love it. And today, when we come home, I'm basically going to pack for a trip. You guys will have a pleasure of joining us on a little bit more than just one adventure. Guys, I don't know if you can see my arm candy at the moment. Finally, after like a month of wearing this watch, I dared to put some jewelry with it as well. So today I wore also my yellow diamond tennis bracelet as well as this because I'm really liking the stack. And we're soon leaving on a little trip with Audemars Piguet. We're going to Saint-Tropez actually. I'm thinking like which watch should I bring with me? Probably this one. Kind of uncharacteristic background for us, but I am actually in my bathroom because I'm gonna have a little bath. And initially I wanted to just tell you how much I've been loving this oil. I really, really discovered a few products recently, including this. I mean, I only got this like maybe a month ago. I haven't used that much of it, but I love it for moisturizing, and it's obviously one of my favorite Chanel scents, which is the Coromandel. I love it for the bath. Besides that, I was thinking which products would I repurchase immediately if I lost my beauty bag, which kind of happened, unfortunately. But one that I love and I've been loving for years now is the Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue fragrance. This fragrance, you guys, I've loved for years. I believe for sure, consistently have used it every single year, 4 years now, since 2017, I believe. But obviously I've used it also when I was in high school, like in, you know, kind of those years. It's like a very not niche fragrance, how do I put it? But it's a fragrance that I love so much that I keep coming back to it. I also think that Dolce & Gabbana Beauty, they have actually changed in the past year, like everything Dolce & Gabbana Beauty. And I'm loving the new products. Foundation that I love right now, if I want to have like a proper foundation, is the Tom Ford Shade and Illuminate Soft Radiance one. And this one has SPF 50, which for me is perfection right now because I need that extra coverage. I recently bought this Chanel Hydro Beauty Micro Serum for lips because I really love the Hydro Beauty Balm. If I'm very honest with you, I'm not that impressed with this. It's kind of like a gel with micro spheres inside, but then after a while it gets kind of sticky. I don't know how to explain it. It's like applying on your lips. It's sweet in taste. It's not soothing. It's too watery. It's too jelly for me. And I suppose you have to apply a lip balm after this. So I wanted to tell you about it in case you also want to buy it like I wanted to buy it, this product over here. Products I love, 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 and I would always repurchase and always and always and always and always are, well, one that I repurchased after it got stolen. Filippo is calling me nonstop. He's the neediest boyfriend that there is in the world.
Say the truth.
I said you're very needy because baby, this is the third time I'm filming something and you're calling my name.
You call me Buddy.
But if you don't answer, baby, if you don't answer, I don't persevere. I love you so much.
Maybe I haven't seen you for a week.
So one palette there I repurchased. I really love this, you guys. It is the Patrick Ta, this one over here, Major Dimension Matte Eyeshadow Palette. I really love it. You can see that I already have used this one a lot and I've been using this one as well. Really, 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 really recommend it. It's so good. For the mascara, Irreplaceable Duo is this Chanel. I actually really love how this smells as well. So this is the base.
the mascara. I don't know how to tell you, I love Gucci Beauty mascara. I also have to give a shout out to the Rosso Ancora lipstick, the one that I used in my TikTok and in the previous video, that I kind of apply here and then smudge it. But now that I got these Rode blushes, I'm really loving them. I think the one that I love the most is Freckle. Freckle and Piggy. This is Freckle. And I don't know if you can see, but it's really nice. Just that Piggy is a little bit more pinky if you want to have more of a pink. This, we were saying today, looks like a Kinder Surprise a bit, which is actually very cute. And what I love about these blushes is that literally you can blend them in with your fingers. And here's the look. I think really, really, really cute. Love the blushes, they're amazing. Absolute favorite eyeliner that nothing can beat is the Hourglass Micro. This is probably like my most gatekept product ever. It's the Hourglass 1.5mm mechanical gel eyeliner in bronze. I also bought it in brown, but the bronze is the one that I prefer. Even though I'm dark, I feel like this is perfectly enough. Pigmented and dark. I wouldn't like it darker than that. For the lip products, now, of course, you guys know I love my Prada Beauty lipstick, but this one is the fairest one. I usually apply this one over the darker one. I have a few that I love. This one, I usually apply first. Yeah, this is it, love it. And I usually do the lip liner as well, and this is the Pat McGrath. I will link it below as well. I love this blush as well. This is the Armani Beauty Neo Nude Melting Color Balm. This is like basically the first ever cream blush. Also, you can apply it with your finger. And the color is really, really nice. I'll try and link it below like everything else so you guys can find it. I also love the Armani Beauty. This is the Prisma Glass Lip Balm that goes then over this lipstick. But then one that I really love and I've kind of finished, you can see this bottle, is also the Buxom Plump Shot. One thing that I would highly recommend as well would be the Kosas Eyebrow Pencil. It's very like high precision pencil. I love the Dior Beauty, Dior Forever Glow on top of the what we just applied here. I mean, I'm gonna wash my face now, so I don't really care how this looks. And then last, but definitely not the least, thing that I would recommend, you guys can get it on Amazon, it's so easy, is this Rosemary Mint Scalp and Hair Strengthening Oil. I don't really care which brand it is. It's not like really brand related. I will link below the oil that I think is the best. I mean, I shop on Amazon literally every single day, you guys. Cannot be helped, I know. And I know that soon they're gonna have the Amazon Prime Day. I don't know about you guys. I don't know if where you live, you use or shop on Amazon as much as my household does, but this is one thing that I'm stocking up on, or not necessarily this one. I will link below the ones that I think are really good. The point is that there are a few things that you need to look at when you're buying rosemary oil or castor oil. And I've spoken about it before, it has to be a certain way of it to be pressed so that you can get all the benefits from the oil. Yeah, I can talk about it more if you guys want it in one of the future videos, but it's really good for your eyebrows, for your lashes. It's really good for hair growth as well. That's a little thing. I'm gonna go have a shower now and go to bed because tomorrow's gonna be a long day. Good morning, guys. Stepping in this room, like trying to not step on anything because I have so much stuff that is like hazardous today. I just got dressed. I'm wearing my Lily Silk top that you could have seen earlier and one of my favorite Totem trousers as well. I realized yesterday I forgot to tell you about this little product over here. I've used, I'd say, a little bit more than half of it. And I'm currently compiling a bit of a list of the things that I need to get when I go next time to Hermes. I mean, we are soon going to Saint-Tropez, so I might pay them a little visit because I really like the Saint-Tropez boutique. They always have like some different things that they don't have anywhere else. Kind of like in Monaco, I suppose. This, honestly, cuticle oil, I can't remember how much it was. For sure, it was like ridiculously, unjustifiably expensive, but it is really, really nourishing. It's honestly like more nourishing than any other that I've tried. Another thing that I recently got on Hermes.com just because I couldn't wait. Normally, I obviously don't shop that much online because we all know it doesn't contribute to the quota, right? But it's this little kind of pendant for the bag. And inside, it's like a tiny little, you would think it's a diary, but it's actually sticky notes. I think it's so cute. But my philosophy behind it is I wanted to try and attempt and decorate one of my bags. Now, let me show you what I've done. So obviously on this bag, I decided to do it because I already had the chrome heart pendant hanging here. And then the first thing that I bought was this little keychain. I really, really love it. I think the color is so complimentary. So I have no idea what color it is. And then I got the Rouge Ash little agenda
not agenda, sticky notes as well. The thing that I do not love, I have no idea where all my Twillies are, but this is the only one that I could find. This one is a little silk scarf from Fendi. I just tied it quickly yesterday, and I don't think this navy is complementing well these tones. Like, imagine if it was something burgundy. This is me trying to Jane Birkin-fy my bag, if you can say so, and I thought, what better bag than a Birkin to do that, so let me know what you think. Other thing that I've been trying to get at Hermes is a little Rodeo, but I don't want the MM, I want the PM one, so the smaller version of Rodeo. When I was in Monaco, they were like, we have it in stock, but we can't seem to find it, so they couldn't really find it, they could only find the MM. Yes, we need to go? Coming. I want to get the PM version of the Rodeo because I really, really love it, but I need to find the right color combo. I saw that they had so many online that I liked. I could have got it online, but Rodeos are a little bit more expensive, so if I can, I would rather get them in a store where it would be more, it would be going more towards my... Oh, probably I need a passport or not. So anyway.
Excuse me?
I was saying,
why are those...
You gave them to me.
Did I?
Yeah. Did you forget?
Try them on.
I think they're a little bit too big.
But they're so cool, baby.
Actually, they're not that bad. It's just that they sit funnily on my face.
Baby, can I steal yours?
Not bad.
Trip?
Of course
those
you
ones.
Can, baby. Anything.
Those ones.
Whatever is mine is yours. Do you guys want me to do a sunglass collection video? Honestly, I kind of tried.
To be honest, oh, guys.
Baby, these glasses are so dirty.
Let me see. Maybe all your girls. No, that's not my fan.
No, I love
so
these
much.
Chanel ones with the pearls on the side.
Yes, we also
I love the Phoebe Philo. They're
yeah.
in my bag.
I also love those chrome art. You
yeah.
should wear them today.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I love these ones, one of my faves. But you know what, baby? There's a pair of Chanel sunglasses that I really love. I'll insert a picture here that you wore and you lost.
They're very old.
Like, they're so old, baby.
Yeah.
This is my first gift I ever got from Fendi. And I really do like them. Let me know if you want me to do a little sunglass collection video. I would definitely consider doing that for you guys because I love you. I think you guys already were saying, but then... Maybe let's have one comment and you guys like it if you want it in the description box below. We gotta go. I love you so much. Thank you so much for joining in, for tuning in, for watching these videos. I really appreciate you guys and I'm so grateful that I can have such an incredible audience and friends online from all around the world. And I say that with all my heart because when I meet you guys, it's really so beautiful. Because I meet you in all the random cities around the world, which is kind of great. It's like a Tamara touring, you know? But then when I meet you, it always feels like we know each other for a long time. So thank you for that. I love you and I'll see you in my next one. Bye, guys.